to have a few words with my old friend, Dr. Bredell.
Save new game. Cancel. Delete previous game. Replace previous game.
Overwriting. Entree.
So, you managed to elude our security. I'll have their heads.
It's over, Bredell. Surrender peacefully, and we'll guarantee you a fair trial.
I will not submit to a trial by a tribunal of chattering apes.
What?
We are the Vardane. Lesser species have no right to judge us.
Your experiment is over, Bredell. Morality transcends the differences in species, Bredell. You don't honestly think you can defy the three of us, do you, Bredell? Your experiment is over, Bredell. Morality transcends the differences in species, Bredell.
This one.
Morality. It is an invention designed to make lesser people feel superior. The universe is full of moral people, and for the most part, they are dead wood. People who are preoccupied with morality never make history. You always did love to lecture, Kirk. You'll be the most self-righteous corpse in the galaxy.
Fire. Yeah, that seemed pretty threatening to me. What about you? Look at everything, including him.
Ies Bredell. For once in his life, he's not a threat to anyone.
Who's this a picture of?
A dartboard.
Oh.
A very good likeness of James T. Kirk is its chief decoration.
Nice.
A shape painting by one of the abstract artists of the Manalvagore Decimator School. Odd. You would expect Bredell's taste to be more classical and realistic.
Decimator School.
A painting of the pyramids of Tenef II. A food replicator.
One that works, I suppose.
Bredell's nightstand. It appears in perfect condition. There is no room for sloppiness in his orderly existence. This seems pointless.
It's a lamp.
The Journal of Ies Bredell.
What about the one under it?
The Journal of Ies Bredell.
Looks like two journals to me.
A vase of red Antarian roses. They have a pleasant aroma. This seems pointless. An Orion fern. The edges of this plant extrude a deadly toxin, but Bredell seems to have had this poison removed. Controls for Bredell's personal computer system.
Well, we're definitely gonna try to check that out.
This seems pointless.
A bed?
Ies Bredell's bed. Oddly enough, the furniture demonstrates a classical taste that you would not have expected from Bredell.
What's this?
A metal table. A metal table.
Metal table with something on it.
A wooden table with some empty plant holders. This seems pointless.
The floor.
The floor. This seems pointless.
Why is it pointless to look at the floor but not the ceiling? Anyway, what's this?
Controls for Bredell's personal computer system.
Actually, let's look.
James Kirk is not in a happy mood right now.
Why not? Apparently we've won.
Spock would not admit it, but Bredell has a certain scientific excellence that he finds admirable. McCoy hopes they can finish this mission soon and get out of here.
Analyze Bredell.
Agent Vardane engineered human male with prosthetic enhancements in average physical condition.
Bredell. Such a charming man.
Reminds me of a Bonovan camel snake.
Let's not insult camel snakes, Bones.
True.
Ies Bredell. Another testimony to your peerless diplomatic skills, Jim.
You think we shouldn't have stunned him? Should I have perhaps killed him?
It is logical that Bredell would wish for the controls for his experiment to be close at hand.
They might very well be on his person. Let's search him. Okay, let's check out the computer. Oh, wait. Wait. Hold on a second. Let's get food.
It seems to be malfunctioning. That is unusual for the Vardane.
You mean they are fallible, Joe?
I think our friend the good Dr. Bredell is proof enough.
So they're all malfunctioning, all the food replicators. Interesting. I wonder why that is. Get the dartboard.
The offending dartboard is removed, revealing a set of controls.
Nice.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Okay, sleepy time then.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
I do not see the logic in that action. The device is an ordinary food machine, Captain.
I'll read it.
Oh, we're gonna read it. Good.
According to this book, Bredell's secret code is 2162.
Got it. Written down.
None of the computer's systems appear to be in control of the proto-event project.
What about this?
I do not see the logic in that action. I do not see the logic in that action. I do not see the logic in that action.
Okay, I don't see logic in actions. But what is this again? This is the computer, and what is this?
This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
Spock's in the way now. I can't look at it.
A set of once hidden controls. There is a key card slot and a number entry pad.
Well, I wonder if the card we have can use it, or can be used with it. Or maybe we should open the... this?
No effect. No effect. No effect.
Alright. Not much else to be done that I can tell, so let's try this key card on it.
The pass card has no effect on the controls, Captain.
Can we search Bredell, possibly?
I don't understand any of this, Jim.
Someone searched the man. Thank you, Spock.
Captain, he appears to be resisting the meld. I am unable to get information from him.
I want to search his body.
No effect. No effect.
We don't have the card, though.
I am inputting the code from the book. 2162. The code
correct.
Is not correct, Captain. It appears to be a trap. I have bypassed the detonation circuit.
Huh. Alright, well. We're looking for
nice
a card.
Table.
Yes.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
What's this here?
They should have built plowshares instead of swords.
That's his phaser? Well, it doesn't work.
It seems to be malfunctioning.
You mean they are
I think our friend...
What if underneath another one of these?
This doesn't really fit the decor.
Is the card underneath it?
No effect.
It appears to be constructed from a silver aluminum alloy, Captain.
Can we get it? Take it? Something? Oh,
Nothing unusual about that object.
I don't want to be doing that. Let's, destroy this and underneath.
I do not believe that is necessary, Captain.
Underneath is the card. We get these books. Maybe under the books.
You pick up Bredell's journal, and a bookmark falls out.
This Aha. is unusual, Captain. I would not have expected a man like Bredell to rely on a paper record.
Who knows, Spock?
Do we have the bookmark? Maybe the bookmark is actually a card. That's the book.
Bredell's journal.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
A bookmark from Bredell's journal.
Take? So what's underneath the bookmark? Another
book. The bookmark is intricately decorated, not
it's
too dissimilar from a computer circuit pattern.
I knew it. So, what book is here now, then?
This seems pointless.
That's another book.
Ah. War and Peace, how ironic. They might learn something from this. Now all they need is crime and punishment. I think I should leave it here.
Okay. In any case, this seems to be the card we need.
Vulcans do not need bookmarks, Captain.
I'm trying to use it. Spock, can you just automatically do it?
I do not see the logic in that action.
You're in the way.
I need the correct code, Captain.
Well, the book said something about 2162, but that appeared to set off a trap.
Affirmative, Captain. I believe that was a deception by Dr. Bredell. We must find the genuine code.
Oh. I figured it was because we didn't use the card.
This doesn't really fit the decor.
Really wish we could search his body. Look for a code here.
None of the computer systems appear to be in control of the proto-event project. I do not see the logic in that action.
Move out of the way. I want to see what this thing is.
I will need the correct code, Captain.
Well, the book said something about 2162, but that appeared to set off...
Affirmative, Captain.
Okay, what is this?
This seems pointless.
Nothing.
This seems pointless.
Okay.
A dartboard with moving target for a real challenge and a phaser-resistant backing. Used to train security officers to fire their phasers more accurately.
If I leave here, is Bredell gonna become alive? I mean, is he gonna wake up again? What's this?
This seems pointless.
Nothing, okay.
A painting of the pyramids of Tenef II.
Pyramids, three sides, two?
A shape painting by one of the abstract artists of the Manalagor Decimator School. Odd.
Well, I can't manually input a code. We have to find a code, so it would be something we haven't looked at yet. I wish we could move this thing.
This doesn't really fit the decor.
Or take it or something.
No effect.
Alright, I think we're gonna have to leave the room. Hopefully he'll still be out when we get back.
Save new game. Replace preview.
This door is labeled Executive Quarters.
So, obviously, with the dartboard, I'm wondering if we can use the dartboard in here.
This door is labeled Crew Quarters.
Crew Quarters, this is Special Projects.
This door is labeled Special Projects Room.
Let's check this out first, because can't help but think we would have gotten more from these computers here.
Captain, there is no need for me to use the controls. The Enterprise is free. I cannot say that I have ever encountered this technology before, Captain. I cannot say that I have ever encountered this technology before, Captain. A standard force field containment cage, Captain.
A computerized bookmark, which automatically stores the last page that was read in micro memory.
Which is what?
Captain, there is a number coded in base 64.
Oh, not this
the
again.
The number is 2188.
So it's going to be the base 4 equivalent of 2188. I'm hoping we can go back and Spock can do that automatically. That's probably our number. Are you awake yet, sir? He's gone. Not trusting that. Alright, so all we did was look at this.
A computerized bookmark which automatically.
There was a puzzle like this similar to in the first game, the 25th anniversary game. We had to figure out what things were in base 3, and I don't really do well with that. And that was the hardest puzzle ever. I just gave up and looked at a walkthrough. I would rather avoid looking at a walkthrough for this. But, who knows?
Captain, there is a number coded in base 64. The number is 2188. The control sequence can only be entered from a science tricorder. I recommend that I be the one to enter the code.
All right, Spock.
Do you know it? Can you just automatically do base 4 for me, Spock? That would be really great of you.
I am inputting the code from the bookmark. 2, 1.
No.
8.
It's in base 4.
I have activated the code circuit. There appears to be fail-safe backup in the central control that needs to be deactivated.
Okay. I figured it had to be in base 4. Okay. Maybe that's automatically in base 4. So you need to go back to central control then. And deactivate something. I'm glad he told us, because I never would have guessed. Central control here. Is it here, I think?
This door is labeled.
Thank you. Guy's still all afraid of us.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Hold on. What if I give this guy the book?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Alright, not necessary.
This seems pointless. This seems pointless. This seems pointless. Dr. Monroe seems to be constantly monitoring data from the console in his chair.
Hmm.
the station's weapon controls. This seems pointless. The station's weapon controls. The main viewing screen. The floor.
The floor.
The station's systems console.
Systems console. So this is nothing well here.
These monitors display ship's external sensor systems.
Okay, we've got external sensors here.
The station's communications station.
Communications.
The station's systems console.
Systems console.
These monitors display ship's external sensor systems.
Let's check those out.
Fascinating. The complexity of this project. If I were human, the word breathtaking would come to mind. Fascinating. The complexity of this project. Captain, since I programmed a destructive sequence into the communications network, it will take several days to repair it. I am disabling their backups. It includes several systems that are not controlled from this station.
Okay, hopefully that's what we wanted to do.
How dare you come aboard this-
And I thought Harry-
So Bredell's gonna be gone again. Whoops. I'm hoping we can just do our thing now.
I am inputting the code from the bookmark. 2188. I have activated the code circuit.
Good.
The proto-event weapon is decloaking. I have also managed to deactivate the station's shields and have a clear communications channel to the Enterprise.
Broadcast the coordinates, Mr. Spock.
We had that already.
Have the Enterprise destroy that weapon.
The coordinates have been sent.
Good.
Scotty, 3 to beam up.
So I guess it doesn't matter where Bredell went? That sounded different. Well, it's kind of a lame beam-up sound.
That has to be one of the most welcome explosions that anyone will ever see.
There is turmoil on the Vardane Council, Captain. The members who supported Bredell's anti-Federation policies have been forced to resign. I expect improved relations between the Federation and Vardane.
That's good to hear. Though history shows that suppressed movements like Bredell's have a habit of resurfacing at inconvenient moments.
And unfortunately, Bredell was not found on the ship. It appears he escaped.
Captain, I'm receiving a message from the USS Alexander.
The Alexander?
Temporal paradoxes are most fascinating, aren't they, Mr. Spock?
Are you attempting to annoy me, Doctor?
Luke Rayner here. I know we've never met.
Yes, of course.
We got your signal, and Starfleet has asked us to assist in cleaning up your operation.
It's good to have you with us. Better than you could possibly guess.
I don't understand, Captain.
It's a long story. Come aboard, and I'll tell it to you.
I reviewed your report from your recent assignment, Captain, and have a few comments. While you achieved the desired results from your assignment, Jim, I can only give you a satisfactory rating.
Damn.
I would expect as much from a cadet.
Oof.
I am concerned about your performance, and I'm going to have to forward my concerns to command. Kane out.
Well, that stinks. I guess it's because he got away. Okay, I'm not sure where we are here, at what point in the game. Can't be that far back.
This door is labeled Central Control.
But let's see, let's deactivate this thing and then deal with him. This way we can take him prisoner, I guess. Bredell, that is.
I am disabling their backups. It includes several systems that are not controlled from this station.
Okay, now that we've accomplished that...
Morality, your experiment is over, Bredell.
Your experiment is over. How about that?
Tell me, Kirk, do you like this place? I prefer to surround myself with beautiful things. The past is the best guide into the future. And it was the future, was it not, that brought us both to gravity's end? I agree that it's time to end it, Kirk.
It's done. Okay. Now we can look at everything. Actually, look at everything.
Captain, there's an energy buildup within the protowave vent. It does not look like a natural phenomenon.
Keep us posted, Lieutenant.
It appears that Bredell is not leaving us much time.
Hmm.
This would appear to be the control system for the proto-event weapon. It is already active and preparing to fire when the conditions in the phenomenon are correct, which would be at any moment. It is targeted on Sector 001.
Earth!
Yep.
That one-eyed monster plans to destroy Earth!
Affirmative, Doctor. I will need Bredell's codes to deactivate it.
Mm-hmm.
Broadcast the coordinates, Mr. Spock. Have the Enterprise destroy that weapon.
We need to deactivate the tractor beam, Captain.
Oh, crap. Which means we leave... Okay. Gotta restore.
Scotty, 3 to beam up.
What about Bredell?
Habit of resurfacing at inconvenient moments.
And unfortunately, Bredell was not found on the ship. It appears he escaped.
You left him.
I'm receiving a message from the USS...
I reviewed your report from your recent assignment, Captain, and have a few comments. While you achieved the desired results from your assignment, Jim, I can only give you a satisfactory rating.
Damn.
I would expect as much from a cadet. I am concerned about your performance, and I'm going to have to forward my concerns to command. Kane out.
Well, that stinks. I'm gonna have to look into how we fix things. How do we get Bredell? He was in the room with us. Shouldn't we just go for to beam up and beam him up with us? Okay, it appears I have forgotten something. I did have to look at a walkthrough for this. We need to go back to Docking Bay 1, I suppose, since this is under construction. Can I go to it? Thank you.
Surrender or die!
Wait, you're supposed to be on our side. Hasn't Commander Command talked to you lately?
Good one.
Can I have 5 minutes to think about it? We surrender. Wait, you're supposed to be on our side.
He is a traitor. Our loyalty is to Dr. Bredell.
Great. Spock, fire. Okay, we surrender. Great. Okay, we surrender.
What if we surrender?
Let's get their weapons.
Great.
7 with 1 ball.
An exaggeration, Doctor.
7?
Come on, you two.
That was 2. Alright, so now we can actually look around in here and stuff.
Spock notes the transparent aluminum doors with passive interest. James Kirk looks for a way to make certain his ship is safe. Dr. McCoy wonders how many more casualties are going to occur on this mission, then wishes he didn't think about such things. An unconscious Vardane guard.
Well, besides that monster, we haven't killed anyone.
An unconscious Vardane guard. This controls the atmosphere within the transport and docking bays. This controls the force field that protects the transport and docking bays. The door into the docking bay.
Danger.
This seems pointless.
Danger is pointless.
This seems pointless. These controls open and close the shuttle bay doors. Storage modules. Storage modules.
Observations, Mr. Spock.
Our chief priority is to find the reason for the Holocaust that was reported by the Alexander and stop it from occurring.
I wish I knew what to do.
Captain, I am quite willing to offer some suggestions, if you wish.
You've already done so, Mr. Spock.
Ask Spock for advice. Maybe if you read the lines in his pointy ears, you can see the future.
That is one of the most irrational statements I have ever heard you make, Doctor.
It was a joke, you green-blooded machine of a Vulcan.
Unfortunately, Doctor, even by human standards, your sense of humor is erratic at best.
Ooh, burn.
They appear to be empty. They appear to be empty.
Okay, analyze stuff.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. Nothing unusual.
Fine.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Nothing unusual about anything.
Nothing unusual.
All right, finally, this thing.
They require a retina scan, a voice pattern, and a key code.
Let me guess, Bredell's.
Dr. Bredell would seem to be exhibiting signs of the human emotion, paranoia.
That's an understatement.
Uh-huh.
The monitor is functioning within specified norms. The magnetic lock is performing well within acceptable parameters.
Now, the whole idea is that Bredell escapes on this shuttle because we stupidly cannot do anything but beam three of us on board and leave Bredell there. It doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever. Perhaps we can use these machines. Well, we can't.
Captain, the door controls have been overridden.
Right.
We might phaser it open, but if the Vardane are capable of controlling the force field barrier, we would be pulled into the vacuum of space.
It's too risky, Jim.
True. True that.
I am unable to open them, Captain.
Spock, could we use this system to give them some sort of erroneous message about their cosmic ray field? Make them believe it's about to collapse. Force them to abandon the station.
Negative, Captain. I would require much more effective access to their monitoring systems.
Do you really think that the real zealots would abandon this project under any circumstances?
Probably not.
Spock, remove the atmosphere.
Now, as far as the walkthrough, I just know we have to mess with his shuttle in some way. I didn't see how, so still kind of blind in a way here.
Spock, sabotage the system.
Sabotage the system.
Spock, remove the atmosphere.
What if we remove the atmosphere?
The atmosphere has been pumped out. Magnetic locks are keeping the transport in place, Captain.
What about this machine?
I do not see the logic in that action.
I can't use that one at all, then.
Spock, restore the atmosphere. Spock, sabotage the system.
Sabotage.
The controls are no longer functioning, Captain.
Is that good?
I do not see the logic in that action.
Did we do it?
Observations, Mr. Spock.
Our chief priority is to find the reason for the Holocaust that...
Is it no longer functioning because we messed with it? I mean, did it lock us out, or did it lock everyone out?
Captain, you asked me to sabotage the controls. It would take several days for me to reverse the damage.
Okay, looks like it's sabotage for everyone. So now he can't get away. I just gotta roll with it. Now, let's try to do this thing.
I will need the correct code, Captain.
We've seen two possible codes, Mr. Spock. 2162. 2188. 2162. 2188.
It's 2188, isn't it?
I have activated the code circuit. The proto-event weapon is decloaking. I have also managed to deactivate the station's shields and have a...
Broadcast the coordinates, Mr. Spock.
The coordinates have been sent.
Scotty, 3 to beam up. Have a happy habit of resurfacing at inconvenient moments.
And unfortunately, Bredell was not found on the ship.
What?
It appears he escaped.
Captain, I'm receiving a message from the USS Alexander.
Okay, evidently we have to sabotage more than one, but he doesn't respond. We'll try him here, too. He didn't say anything. Maybe I had it pointed wrong.
Spock, open the outer door. Spock, sabotage the system. Spock, open the outer door.
Captain, the door is open. Magnetic locks are keeping the transport in place, Captain.
These controls are unfamiliar to me.
No kidding, that's why we use Spock.
Captain, you asked me to sabotage the controls. It would take several days for me to reverse the damage.
Okay, what about this?
Spock, could we use this system to give them some sort of a...
Negative, Captain.
Do you really think that the real Zell...
I am unable to open them, Captain.
Okay, let's sabotage this then.
Spock, close the outer door.
Close the outer door.
Spock, sabotage the system.
The controls are no longer functioning, Captain. Captain, you asked me to sabotage the controls. Captain, you asked me...
Okay, hopefully that will be enough, because I really want to put this episode to rest. It's really late, and I have work, and I need to, like, get sleep and stuff. Bredell is here.
Scotty, 3 to beam up. Have a habit of resurfacing at inconvenient moments.
And Bredell is now a Federation prisoner.
Yay!
I hope this will not prove to be a rallying point for those of Ardane who hate the Federation.
Captain, I'm receiving a message from the USS Alexander.
The Alexander?
Temporal paradoxes are most fascinating.
Are you attempting to annoy me?
On screen.
Luke Rayner here. I know we've nipped...
Yes, of course.
We got your signal, and Starfleet has asked us to assist in cleaning up your...
It's good to have you with us.
I don't understand, Captain.
It's a long story. Come aboard, and I'll tell it to you.
I have reviewed your report from your recent assignment, Captain, and have a few comments.
That'd be better.
Well done, Kirk. Keep up the good work. I must say, however, your performance is not what we've come to expect from James T. Kirk. I guess we all have our off days, Captain. Kane out.
Well, a little better. I'm taking it. Probably if we had dealt with that, first security guard instead of locking him in the cell and stunning him, I suppose. Sentinel, a peek in the next episode.
Captain, I'm looking forward to taking leave on Nova Atar. The museum there is supposed to be quite excellent. Lots of antique and one-of-a-kind machinery.
Commander, are you certain it's not the Kazakhstanian cognac you're looking forward to?
Do they make that there, laddie? I don't know.
Why, Mr. Scott, I'm surprised at you, not knowing the location of a famous distillery.
We invented that brandy, you know.
Right.
Of course you did.
No, really.
It's funny.
We did.
No
that
one
laugh.
Would ever doubt you, Ensign, however...
Sorry to interrupt, Captain, but we have an emergency call from the science vessel Demeter. She's in orbit around Balkos 3.
On screen.
Okay.
Captain Kirk, good to see you're in the area.
You have an emergency, Commander Gelman?
Well, I'm not sure, actually. Maybe more of a case of better safe than sorry. We're orbiting Balkos 3 to study the Balkosi, a race of people just entering their own Stone Age. We've only been here 2 days. Already, we've found some unusual data. But just a few minutes ago, during the deep geologic probing phase, we were suddenly scanned.
Scanned? I thought the Balkosi were just developing.
They are, Captain. And there haven't been any indications of old civilizations until now. The scan was also of extreme power. Following that, we detected a power source coming online.
Uh-oh.
We'll send the coordinates along with all the other information we've gathered. I was a little concerned that we triggered an old defense mechanism. With the amount of information it pulled in its scan, we'd be an easy target. I've moved the Demeter to a higher orbit on the far side of the planet.
Quite reasonable, Commander. We're on our way.
Thank you, Captain.
Kirk out.
Okay, and we will continue that next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.